It looked like somebody was bent over and had their head in the window of the deer blind. It either heard me or smelt me, and he pulled his head out of the tent and stood straight up, and that shocked me. They don't make people that big.
The way it moved, almost as if it was gliding across the beach. I've never seen anything move like that in my life. They were screaming at each other in gibberish. It sounded like a language, and they were chuntering away back and forwards, back and forwards, back and forwards. I know what a bear looks like, and there is no way on this planet that what I saw were bears.
Jesus Christ, you better... Sheriff? Gia!
Hello?
Get somebody out here.
What's going on now, sir?
That son of a bitch is about 6'9", I don't know.
Do you see him now, sir?
Yes, I'm looking right at him.
Uh-oh.
This is Wyatt coming from Oklahoma, and you're listening to Sasquatch Chronicles.
Welcome to the show, everyone. Thanks for being here tonight. Got a great show planned for you tonight. I'm officially moved, and I've been moving all week. Middle of the night, moving stuff. During the day, every moment I get a chance, I'll start moving stuff. And I physically hurt. I think I'm getting old. That might be it. I think this moving stuff is for the young man. But I basically set up a skeleton studio in my new place just to get a show out for you guys tonight. And I really appreciate you guys being here. Tonight, we're going to be chatting with Stephanie. And Stephanie comes to us from Missouri. And she had a very unique encounter when she was young. I'll kind of let her tell the encounter. But she came face to face with this thing. And as Stephanie and I were talking off the air, she was kind of describing it to me. She said it wasn't really skin. It was more like leather. It was a real bizarre texture to the skin. And we're also going to be chatting with Bob. And Bob comes to us from California. I spoke to Bob a couple days ago. And Bob was telling me about this encounter he had when he was very young. He said he didn't know what it was, what they had run into. And it wasn't until later in life that he realized what they actually saw that day. Very fascinating encounters. And I love childhood encounters, you know, when people come back as adults and retell something that happened to them when they're kids. It's very telling. If you've had an encounter and you'd like to be on the show, shoot me an email. My email address is wes@sasquatchchronicles.com. And let's jump into it tonight, everyone. I want to welcome Stephanie to the show. Stephanie, thanks for coming on.
Thank you. Appreciate you having me.
Yeah, I really appreciate you coming on, Stephanie. You know, I was fascinated by your email and you and I talking. You know, you were telling me how your mom didn't believe you at the time, but now she does. I don't want to ruin the encounter. If you would you just kind of start from the very beginning? Kind of tell us what you were doing and what happened.
Yeah, so we lived in an area of Missouri called like Big Bend. And so I was around, this is probably like 1977, 1978. I was like 7 or 8 years old. And it's a very woodsy area. And I remember we lived in this house in a very woodsy part of this area. And like where your neighbor's like a quarter mile away, but it's very woodsy and you have to go through the woods to get to your neighbor. And I remember one afternoon it was, and I don't remember the season, if it was spring or summer. It was sunny. It was during the day. And I remember my brother and my sisters, we went over to our neighbor's house to go play with the neighbor kids. Our neighbor, to give you some context, our neighbor had a mountain lion as a pet. And they kept it in this chain link fence cage. And so we had went over to play with the neighbor kid, and I had gotten mad at my siblings about something. And I said I was going home. So I was walking back through the woods back to our house, which is probably about a quarter mile away. And I was going to go tell my mom, you know, I was upset about something. And as I was walking through the woods, I just had this feeling of being watched, but not like prey. And I remember, didn't feel like I was in danger, but I definitely had a sense I was being watched. And I remember stopping, remember looking around, and I remember continuing. And because I knew, I was warned with my parents, you know, be careful because there are, you know, mountain lions and coyotes and stuff in the area. And so I started going back home, and I stopped again. And I remember looking around, and I remember probably around 30 to 40 feet away, because the trees in Missouri are very like tall and kind of thin. And not a lot of brush at the bottom of the trees. And so I looked and I saw something like looking around the corner of, of this tree. And it was very tall. And it had like reddish brown hair. And it was kind of like on the thinner side. And it had no hair on the face. It was more like a leathery face. And I remember looking and I kept thinking, like, is this something? I had never heard of a Bigfoot. I did not know what this was at all. And I kept thinking in my head, because I'm very logical, and I was a logical kid, I kept thinking, is this something my parents had told me about that I'm forgetting? Like, I'm kind of going through my mind thinking, okay, it's not a mountain lion. Okay, it's not this. Is there something I'm missing they've warned me about that I'm missing? I don't remember how long I looked at it, but I just felt like, this is really strange. I've never seen this before. Did my mom tell me about this? And I forgot. And I just remember kind of like, okay, I better go. And then I just took off and ran home. And I do remember telling my mom when I got home, but she kind of dismissed it. She didn't really believe me, but ever since that time, I'd had these continuous like nightmares about this tall creature, which I later put two and two together when I found out what a Bigfoot was, that it was probably a Bigfoot I saw. It was like more of a Chewbacca type, you know, it's kind of tall and lanky. And always had these dreams of Bigfoot peering into windows, of this creature peering into windows looking at me and, you know, chasing me through the woods. And it kind of really haunted me for kind of years. And like, even when the show, you know, Finding Bigfoot started, I couldn't even watch it because it would just kind of bring me back there to that day. Yeah. So it's kind of weird, you know what I mean? But I kind of came to terms with it in a way. And so, I don't know. I don't know. Again, I didn't know what it was that I saw because I had never heard of a Bigfoot before. Until I got older.
Yeah. Can I ask you, Stephanie, when you saw it, did it, the face, did it look more human? Did it resemble more of a non-human primate? I mean, how would you kind of describe the face of when this thing was looking at you?
You know, it does have a human appearance because it doesn't look quite like a primate, but the skin, like there wasn't like, even though it had like long, kind of like long, like fur or hair, whatever it is, and it was reddish and brown, the face was more like this, like leathery kind of skin on it. So it's kind of like this hybrid kind of thing. It's kind of like, it didn't look exactly like a primate, but it didn't look exactly like a human either. So I don't know quite how to describe it, but it didn't have a lot, it didn't have hair on a face. It was just around the face. I don't remember the mouth so much, to be honest. I just remember the forehead, the eyes, the nose, and I just remember it kind of being leathery. And I remember the fur being long and, or hair, whatever it was. And I remember it being kind of tall and lanky. That's what I remember.
Yeah.
I remember being very tall.
Yeah. Yeah, they generally are. The other question I wanted to ask you was, did the facial expressions change at all when you guys made eye contact?
Yeah.
Did his facial expressions change?
Mm-mm. No. No. It didn't really have an expression. It was kind of expressionless. And I remember kind of just...